everybody. It is Abby again, and I'm doing something very special today. I get to unbox and try out and experience for the first time the brand new Sony Access controller. Got this. What's in the box? Basically a accessible Access controller, my dog just barked, developed by Sony with special attention and care and a lot of work and research to allow folks with any sort of cognitive or physical impairment to game just like everybody else. So let's get started. Here's my dog Pongo. He doesn't know what's going on, but he wants to chew on it. Actually, the PlayStation controllers historically have been a little harder for me to use because the gamepad typically has been just smaller profile than this, but this is the DualSense PS5 controller, and it's a little bit larger body than in past versions. And so I've been playing on it some the past couple of weeks, and it is a lot easier for me to use. So that's cool, but let's find out how this is. Okay, got my scissors. Got Pongo. If you're not new here, you've seen me play games like on Super Nintendo and stuff. I have grown up playing games casually. Get your booby dog. Okay. Cool. No. 5 years ago, Sony 5 years ago started developing this controller. I'm familiar with this type of thing, access tools and technology of different kinds, and it takes a long time. And people who do this, companies who do this, really have to dedicate a lot of time and resources to make something like this a reality. And so I can always appreciate when I get to handle something like this and just know that it exists, because it means that folks out there care to make sure that everybody is involved or can be involved in their product. I think that's very cool. Thank you, Sony. The final paragraph says, "The Access controller reflects our commitment to embracing a spirit of innovation that genuinely broadens the horizons of play and invites more players to share in its joy." I can attest to that. Okay, so we have here two of the Access controllers. For a moment I was like, why did they send me two? And then I realized two of these can be linked together. It depends on your level of accessibility that you need. They can be linked together. I feel like I might only use one, but if you need to have, let's say, if you have motor skill issues or whatever, and you have limited movement and dexterity on either of your hands, it's very, I think, probably be super helpful to have two of these, one on left and right. Very nice packaging, quality, ease of use. That thing's, you know what I just realized about this? That the way that you open this box is accessible. Because just a couple of weeks ago, I got the PlayStation, and it's, you know, it's normal. It's like just regular, how you would expect to experience to unbox something like that. But that was so cool. So Sony being thoughtful, even just with the packaging of the Access controller. Very nice. Okay. Oh, did I do it upside down? Sure did. Awesome. Okay. So this is a diagram of each button. Right, cool. Oh, nice. Okay. Wow, this is cool. Okay, so here is the bones of the thing. Just as I expected, everything is just nice quality, obviously sturdy. I need to charge this up, I think, for a little while. Okay, this is really cool. You know what? It's always different unboxing something than like seeing it online ahead of time to preview it. So what you get to do here is not just assign in the settings your buttons dedicated to each of these however you want to assign them to each of these physical buttons. Sony has included different physical, designs and feel of each of them. The one that comes just out of the box right now, so right now these buttons, see, like, they're more rounded. Hopefully you can see that. Dome sort of feel style. And yeah, so you can remove, like, if this style doesn't work for you physically, if it's not the one that's gonna help you the most, then you can pop it off. That was very easy. And let's say this one's scoopy, bit like a chip, and you can pop this one on, and that comes on so easy, it's ridiculous. See, now, I really connect with this because sometimes a paddle style, however you want to call this one, would be, like, for me, a paddle style would be easier because the way that my paw is shaped on the end, I want to be able to, almost like a finger, be able to touch. Not palm, but a precise touch. You know what I'm saying? You two-handed folks, you get what I'm saying? Wow, look at that. Holy moly. You know, as a kid, could I ever have imagined myself holding something like this and doing something like this? Something as advanced as this, like, compared, I was like a 90s kid, you know, advanced compared to that. Drop a comment below if you think that Parappa the Rapper was super hard. It was. It can't be just me. Again, with the customization thing, you've got, like, endless possibilities to customize this how you want. These are buttons, like buttons on, like the indicators for buttons, like, okay, pops off like those little candy dots, remember those? And I'm guessing, yep, just pop it right in. So you can assign these however you want. Very cool, very thoughtful. I absolutely love it. Three different options for your joystick control. One, this is the jumbo sort of flat style. I popped that off easy. Two, small. This is like, it looks exactly like the one on the standard controller here. Pop that one on if that's what works for you. And three, this one's like an arcade style. If you need more, if you need to be able to reach less or be less precise. This is how I do things. Then, like, if I had limited motion, say, my hand didn't move, my fingers didn't move, but my hand could move, like, we can do just something as simple as that. And it seems like it's pretty sensitive. I would guess you can change the sensitivity about that on that, but yeah, that's cool. I love that. Okay, I have talked about the actual physical setup a lot. I am going to charge this up and then we can play a little bit and see how it feels. Okay, it's a different day. So I needed to charge it up and then I realized I need to spend some time using this because it is simple to use once you set it up, but it's intricate to set up because every person who uses one of these access controllers is going to have a different set of needs and customization, etc. So I was like, okay, how am I even gonna figure this out for me? And so I've had a chance to play with it a little bit and assign the buttons, so I will show you that. So basically I have, I guess you could call it version one of what my access controller will be over time as I play with it more. So this has, you know, I basically pulled all the buttons put the buttons on as I felt like would work for me. And so, like, as you can see here, I have square and the X and the circle buttons on the right side. And those, I changed out the paddles or the tactile bits, I forgot what they called, here on the right side, but not on the left side. And the reason for that is this. So, with a regular controller, I typically will be playing with a pillow on my lap because holding it up into the air so that my paw can reach it is uncomfortable after like 1 minute. So I do the same here. I need the height. So The reason for these being different than those, so like these are like the bubble sort of protruding style buttons on the left side versus on the right side, so that my paw basically can, I have an easier time pressing those buttons. It's hard to explain why, but it's like, it feels like I'm going to be accurate every time I press down with my paw, more so on this style than these. And then I have this medium size joystick. That is the physical game pad that I have now customized for myself. The other portion of it, which is the more intricate part of it, is the setup. And basically with the setup, you have, Sony has done an incredible job of allowing you to go really deep with customizing. So I went through the whole setup screen. You can choose, you can have three different preset profiles for your gamepad. What I didn't mention before, there is a quick button to change the profiles. So that's here on the side. And so you can press that and switch profiles quickly. And then two other things that I didn't mention before. On the front of the Axis controller is the charging input, but also there are four inputs for four separate controllers that you can plug into the Axis controller as sort of like the main hub. So you got, if you need a separate joystick or if you need a separate button pad, whatever it is, it's this is very customizable to the point of being expandable. And I didn't mention before that the standard DualSense controller here that I have can be connected also to the Axis controller. So my biggest takeaway from playing with the Axis controller for a little bit compared to a standard controller, I was playing Rocket League, which is really fun. I just recently discovered that. And what I'm getting, because I have more distance with the Axis controller, is more precision with my turns. I wouldn't have ever expected that. I'm like, always been pretty good at driving games. But what I'm doing is basically, I have more distance, more like a better grip, I guess, on the Axis controller versus the regular one, because I have the needed distance. And it's hard to describe with words, but basically, like, if I can hold it out here or kind of have it resting like this, and I have like what feels like more of a handle, like literally, on the Axis controller with room and feeling like I have the security of being able to move between buttons on the Axis controller, it gives me a little bit more, I think, just ability to be more precise. It's hard to put in words, but that's my initial impression is after playing some. In comparison, I have to be super tight. Like, I have to, like, it's all right here, and if I have to move around at all, like, I have to like pull the controller closer to me. So far, that's a perk and advantage of the way that the Axis controller is customizable and laid out in general, and the size of it. All right, here we go. We're gonna play a little Rocket League. Now, I understand Rocket League is not your most complicated game when it comes to controllers, but bear with me. These things take time. The fact that I'm able to play better, essentially, though, just in Rocket League versus with the Axis controller versus the regular controller, I mean, that tells me something. All right, so I love this game. This is very fun. So we're gonna go do one versus one, duel, casual. I'm nowhere near a competitive level yet. I just started playing like last week, so. All right, here we go. Here we go, baby. All right, so Rocket League basically is like just a few, you can like do a power slide, you can jump, you can turbo, and then you just have to drive decently. I have the controls set up that work for me. Oh, the guy got it first. That's not good. Oh, there he goes. Oh, no, he missed. Are you serious? That works for me. Oh, back in my side, baby. Yeah, I just drive better with this. I don't know how to explain it. It's just the way I'm holding the Axis controller versus the regular one, it just works better for me. It's so crazy. I don't know. Oh, that's a score for Abshuno. Oh, almost was. Come on, baby. Guys, don't make fun of me if you play this game. I just said, last week's my first time playing. Leave me alone. Oh, he's going to score. No, he's not. Yes, he is. No, he's not. Yes, he is. Boom. Move. Get your butt. Oh. Come on, one! Yes! Okay, I got one goal, that's fine. Match is almost over. What do we got, 19 seconds? One goal. I swear to you, the makers of Rocket League could go back and prove this. I won my first three, like, allowing 1 point, but not this time. This guy's good. Just don't score me again, it's just embarrassing. Oh, I could have gotten that last goal. Gosh. Oh, wow. I got blown out. That was fun anyway. So, you see what I'm saying about this thing? I mean, and I'm just scratching the surface. I'm just basically doing, like, my initial thoughts and review, unboxing, what have you. Point is, this thing is amazing. Let me turn this off. So, what you get with this is essentially the ability to game. Like, to play modern games. To compete with friends and strangers all around the world, no matter what your physical ability is or is not. I do think that Sony has really knocked it out of the park with this one. I think this is a really special device. I think that this is probably way even above my head at this point, which is cool, which is just basically tells you that the possibilities are nearly endless in terms of how this is gonna help people. So, links below, check it out. As always, thank you so much for watching. I have a lot more to learn, a lot more to experience with this Access controller. I hope that you've gotten value out of this video. I certainly have. Thank you, Sony, and I will see you next time.